Thank you very much, Andrei and Moitza, for the invitation. As you can see from the first slide, I have two caps. Actually, I am a cluster manager of first Hungarian packaging technology cluster. On the other hand, I am a business unit manager at the Dutch-Hungarian group of companies specialized in business development and venture capitalism. You should know that in Hungary, clusters do not have a legal status. So clusters are officially represented either by an NGO, a non-profit organization, or even by a private company. And in this case, we are representing the cluster. Actually, we took over cluster management 4 years ago. And before, I didn't have any real knowledge in the packaging industry. And still, of course, I'm not considered as an expert in packaging. I am more inclined for business development. In BioCompact project, we are responsible for the pilot actions, but since we will start implementing pilot actions in August, September, still I have nothing to speak about that, although we have done already our task in elaborating the paper plastics packaging value chain in Hungary, so I would like to tell you some examples of Hungarian biopackaging, starting with some very general figures from Europe or from the world. So you can see that according to some forecasts, the share of Europe in the distribution of production from renewable resources will be decreasing in the coming years. You will see that Asia will have an even bigger portion. You can also see that according to forecasts, biodegradable and bio-based but and non-biodegradable products will be more and more important. And some bioplastic manufacturers in Europe, you can see the capacities as well. However, probably you know these figures or you know all these companies. And now I would like to get back to Hungary. So in Hungary, the regulation is not really supporting biodegradable or bioplastic production or use of bioplastics. It is rather difficult also to set up a domestic base of production capacity. About 6 years ago, Nitrochemia Zrt, which used to be the largest, one of the largest Hungarian chemical conglomerate in the past, just on the shore of the Balaton Lake, of course, where to put such a big chemical plant. So they plan to make a joint venture with a huge Chinese company. And they wanted to produce 80,000 tons per year. But still, although there are negotiations, the project has slowed down, and still there is no bio refinery production capacity in Hungary. Probably the figures are the same in all other countries, but in Hungary, prices of plastics consisting of renewable resources or biodegradable plastics can be three more times more expensive than bulk plastics. However, if you go for PLA, it's a kind of exception because then the multiplier is only 1.5. So it can be used, and there are chances to use PLA or to implement it onto the Hungarian market. The situation is even better in case of paper cups coated by PLA or normal PE, and in case of other paper products coated with PLA, because then the selling price would be augmented only by the extent of the PLA raw material. So there is a real chance of this kind of products to enter the Hungarian market. Or they entered already, but there are some slight chances to have a larger share. However, as I told you, the situation is not really supporting bioplastics industry or use of bioplastics. As an example, although there are some very nice examples, for example, Burger King in Hungary, it's quite a big chain in Hungary, you should know. They are open for environmentally friendly products on the domestic market. And currently, there is a need of about 10 tons per year for this kind of materials, and some members of Omnipac are already selling to Burger King. We also try to get access to McDonald's, but there are some obstacles to get in. So Burger King is much more, how shall I put it, it's easier to talk to Burger King, and they are really committed, I think, for environment friendly products. Getting back again for the production, so a normal biorefinery plant can be economical only if they have a capacity of 40,000 or 50,000 tons per year. However, you see the big difference that in case of paper lined cups, the annual demand would be maybe 100 or 150 tons in Hungary. So it's really useless, I would say useless economically, to set up such a plant in Hungary. Although currently we have pilot experiments running in the manufacturing industry with PLA granulates from the US and from China. So we are testing films and other coatings. Getting back to Omnipac, so we are one of the first Hungarian clusters, and as you thought, we are the biggest packaging cluster. I think we have two or three clusters, so it's not difficult to be the biggest one. And of course, we are committed to a broader spread of biodegradable packaging materials. Although, in spite of what I have told, we are a small cluster, so we have only 24 members, about 200 million euro as a turnover altogether, and 1,000 employees, 22 SMEs, one university, and one big company. So even in Hungary, this cluster can be considered as a small one. So we are now encouraged to merge with another cluster, because the Hungarian cluster policy will go into the direction to support only big clusters. They still don't know how, but they are always telling us that we should merge with someone. So now we have negotiations with the food cluster, where we can have complementary services, but probably we will merge with an environment cluster, which has also 24 members. So our cluster is vertically structured. We are covering the whole value chain, and although we are each other's competitors in some segments, but there are no real coverage of competition. So we are a strategic alliance of companies working in the similar market segment. We have special thematic focuses. I don't want to go into details, and then we cannot really see it, but we can cover all the phases of the value chain. Just last week I have been to Bucharest, because we had an own stand at the exhibition of PAC Expo, PAC Expo Bucharest, and this is one of the products which had a great success. It's 100% biodegradable material. It's a green fill or a filling material. It's totally natural. We are already delivering it to web stores, delivery companies, air transport companies, environment-friendly firms. It's based on cornstarch, and we use this instead of PS or EPS. Although it is economical only in a circle of 200 kilometers, and you know that if you are in Budapest, the company is based in Budapest, so if you go on to the Romanian-Hungarian border, it's already 200 kilometers. However, as a pellet, it can be economical to transport in a wider range of kilometer, wider kilometer range, if there are machines which can blow this material up from granulates, from pellets, and the company which is producing the material, they are also trading with this kind of machinery. So I think that they have a nice development process in this phase. And why we can help our cluster members from other points of view? As I told you, we are a bigger Hungarian Dutch company originating from Debrecen, Hungary, actually. So we are not a big Dutch company which set up a sister company in Hungary. We started about 25 years ago. We have offices in the Netherlands, Hungary, Romania, Czechia, or Czech Republic. And we also incubate startups. We have a venture capital fund, so we invested about 20 million euro into small and medium-sized enterprises in Hungary. Since we are one of the Hungarian Jeremy funds, we have there are 8 Jeremy funds in Hungary, so it's European money, but you can use it only into investing it into small and medium-sized company. We have invested into 10 companies, and we have to make the exit in 2 years, actually. We also provide corporate business services, so accounting, trust services in the Netherlands, business development, and we do have real estates in Budapest, Miskolc, Debrecen, and Bucharest. And I am leading the business development unit, which can help Central Eastern European companies to get access to mainly the Dutch and the Belgian markets. I would like to tell you that, or encourage you to get access with your products to the Dutch market, because in many cases, you know, that Central European companies sometimes are more mature, even in the field of environmental friendly issues, but in other stuff, IT, for example, as well, then they are more mature than the local markets. Actually, in Hungary, this is the case, and an international validation would be needed. But many Hungarian companies think that they should go to the Silicon Valley first, but I would recommend them to stay in Europe. The cultural difference is not so big, and even physical difference is not so big. So the Dutch market could be a good destination for all kind of even bio-based package products, since the Dutch market is receiving friendly this kind of inventions even from Hungary. So even from Central European countries, they do not really care where the innovation is coming from. And also another issue is that the Dutch market or the Dutch legal structure is much more adaptable to the needs of this kind of startups or smaller companies. And that's my last sentence, is Hvala za vašu pozornost. I hope that I have made a good pronunciation.